Hey guys, I'm back with another tutorial series on AutoCAD. In this tutorial series, I will going to show you how to create a house plan, 2D house plan, front, that means ground floor plan, first floor plan, and elevation, side view, back view, and cross sectional area. After that, I'm going to convert it into 3D a model. Okay, so I will give it a material and render it in AutoCAD. So this is the first part. In this tutorial I will going to show how draw a house plan for ground floor and first floor. We give it a door, provide a doors, window space, and so let's get start. To draw a house plan, first of all we are change the unit or specify the unit in AutoCAD. For that we are simply go to unit, so simply press U and for unit and press enter. Now you are see here drawing unit pop up. Okay, so here we are change the length to the decimal, precision up to 2, and most important we are use the unit scale in the meters. Okay, now click this clockwise sign and rest of the settings remain same and click on OK button. Okay, so now our units are set up. Now going here for snap mode. In snap mode, first three means endpoint, midpoint and center, these three are checked, always checked. Okay, so now I can close it by clicking here. Now I can go to layer properties and click on it. Now you can see layer properties menu is open. Now we are create a different layers for our drawing. So we are going to click new layer by clicking here, and first layer I want to name it walls, create another one and give it a name of door, create another one called windows, create another one called dimensions. Okay, create another one for furniture. Okay, now we can change the color because everything is white, it's not look so good. So in walls I can stay with the color white. For door I will choose a green color. For windows I will choose a blue color. For dimension I choose a red one, and for furniture I will take a yellow color. Okay, you can take any color you want. Now we are go to wall layer and double click on it for activate. Okay, activate this layer. Now I can close this by simply click on close button. Okay, for that now we are going to first of all create a garage. For garage we are going to this rectangle icon, click on it. Now specify first point, and now we are going to create an accurate rectangle. For that give it a dimension, for so you can simply press D and enter. Now we are take that dimension of 5.8 meter, enter, and 4.3 meter. Now press enter. Now it asks for where you want to put it. Now this side or this side. I can put it this side and click here. Oh, I forgot to say turn off the grid because we don't want it. So our garage is ready. Now we are create a storeroom. Okay, beside the storeroom is here, at the garage. So we can again go to rectangle, specify first point, press D, enter, and give it dimension 3.7 meter by 1. Let's take a 2 meter. Okay, and simply enter. Now we are going to create a kitchen by simply go to here and create a rectangle of 3.7 by 3.7 meter. Now give a offset of this storeroom and kitchen. Okay, to do that simply type OF and enter and give it offset of 0.3 meter outward. Okay, so simply click here, drag it and click again. Now same procedure do with this. Now I'm going to arrange these two at here. Okay, so cancel the command. I will press escape P. Now select these two rectangles, press M for move and enter. Now I am select this corner and put it again select this corner, press M and enter. Now I can move it up to here. Okay, now we are going to move these two, press M, enter, click here and simply put it to here. Okay, now press escape for the cancel command. Now we are going to create a bedroom, okay, which is located here. Again we are going to rectangle, specify first point, press D, enter. Now we are going to give a dimension of 3.6 meter by 3.2 meter. Okay, now we are going to create a bathroom with here. Okay, so again go to rectangle and create a bathroom of 3.6 meter by 2 meter. Okay, now give offset of 0.3 meter outward side. So simply click and now press escape. Now we are going to move these two rectangles. So simply press M and enter. Now click here, put it here. Now select these two, press M, enter, click here, put it here. Okay. Now we are going to create a dining area over here. Create a rectangle of 5.6 meter by 4.7 meter. Okay. Now give offset of 0.3 outward. Press escape and select these two rectangles. Press M to move and click specify endpoint here and move it up to here. Okay, now we are going to create our living room and attach with the stairs. Okay, so I'm going to create a simple rectangle. I give it a dimension for a 6 meter by 4.1 meter. Okay, now create a line, click here, give it a dimension of 1.5 meter, enter. Now you can extend the line up to this point. Okay, now press escape. Now what I'm going to do, I'm simply give a offset of 1.5 meter from here to here. Okay. Now press escape. Now you can move this because we don't know what is the length of the stairs. Okay. So again, click on line here. And don't need to give a dimension up to here. Okay, so simply press on escape. Now what we are going to do, we are use the array to create these stairs. For that I will choose the rectangular array going up to here and select on rectangular array. Now select the object and now click here, right, select this. After that you can right click. Okay, so sorry, it's my mistake. Press Ctrl Z for the undo. Now go to rectangle array, click on here and right click. Okay, now you are fine, you are at array creation menu. Okay, for the column you add 5, sorry, you add 1 column, and at rows you can change it to 5 because there is a 15 stairs, 5 stairs here and 10 stairs here. Okay, so give a 5, change distance between them 0.3 meter. Okay, now you can see here is the change everything. Okay, so now simply press enter to exit from that. Now you can simply create a line up to here, press escape, select this, trim command activate by tr, space enter, and simply, sorry it does not work, simply click here on this line, simply shift point to here. Now what we are going to do, we are going to create a 10 stairs here. So again go to rectangular array, select this object, right click, and now you can give rows of 1 and columns up to 10, sorry minus 10, because this is the this cell, we want it to this cell, so we will give a minus 10. Now minus 10. Okay, now we distance between them minus 0.3. We give it the minus sign over here and enter. Now you can see there is a 10 stairs that are created. Now go to home tab, press line, simply click here to here, press escape. Now our stairs are ready. Now what we are going to do, we are select everything from here, press M for move and enter. Now we can going to move this from this point and put it here. Now create a one other line from here to here. Okay, now we are going to give a offset of this, okay, of 0.3 meter. Now simply click rectangular and give offset here, and last one here. Okay, now what we are going to do, we are don't need this one. Okay, so some parts I want to trim, or some parts here we are fillet. Okay, so now I can show you how to do it. Simply click and select all area. Now simply press tr for trim, and now we can remove this one, and this one also. Now you can see our excessive lines are deleted. Now we are create a fillet over here and here. To activate fillet command, simply press F and enter. Now you can select here this line and this line, and for continue command you can simply press the space bar. It's again activate. Now you can select these two lines. Now our living area and stairs are created. Now what we are going to do, now we are going to put its desired location. Okay, so simply click and select all, press M and enter. Now select this part, and sorry, select all this, press M, enter. Select this corner because we want to parallel this corner. So here and here. Now we can simply place here. Okay, now create a line from here to here, space for exit. Now what we are going to do, we are create doors and windows for this. Now you can see there is a extension for the garage for up to here to here, so we can create a line again. So this time we will choose polyline. Click here and here. Okay, simply press escape. Now select this command trim, enter. Now simply okay, everything is good. Now there is several beams are here, 1, 2, and 3 here. Okay, there are 3 beams, so we are going to create that by simple rectangle. These beams are rectangle, so press D, enter, and give it a 0.6 meter by 0.6 meter. Okay, now we are copy this beam, select, move, enter, select the point and move it up to here. Sorry, now we are copied. So select CP command to copy and enter. Now take it from the here and put it here. Now one beam is at here and press escape. Okay, because in a front floor here is a one bedroom provided, so we can put this beams, sorry, columns. Now what we are going to do, we are going to create a main door here. So give a offset of 1 meter or say 1.2 meter. Okay, so give a offset of 1.2 meter. Simply press escape, again OF, and give a offset of 0.3 meter for the wall, and simply okay. Now press escape. Now our main walls are almost ready. Now we are going to create a passage for the doors. Okay, so now we are going to create a simple line. Now our middle point toggle snap is work for us, and we are simply find a midpoint and simply click here and here, make a line, press escape. Now what we are going to do, we are going to create a door of 1.2 meter wide. So we are going to give a offset of 0.6 meter both the sides, left and right side. So simply press enter. Now click on it, simply right side, again left side, press escape. Now select this area and activate the command trim by pressing TR and enter. Now what we are going to do, delete this layer and this layer and these three, okay, and simply press escape. Now this line is not needed, so simply click on it and delete key on the keyboard. Now our main door area is created. Now what we are going to do, we are going to create a door for this bedroom and this here, okay. So first of all, create a simple line here and press space bar from it to exit it. Now what can I do, I give a offset of a 0.1 meter, sorry, 0.1 meter, okay. Now we are again giving the offset of a 1.2 meter here for the door. Now we are selecting this area, simply press TR, enter. Okay, simply press escape and delete this line, we don't need it. Okay, now what we are going to do, from here we are again give a offset of a 10 cm, for that give a offset of 0.1 meter, enter, give it here, press escape, create a line, first point here, another one at here, okay, simply click here. Now this is our washroom area, so the wall thickness of this is, we are going to take a 0.2 meter, okay, so give a offset of 0.2 meter here to here and simply press escape. Now we are create a door here for the entrance of this bathroom. Before that we are delete this line, we don't need it now. Now what we are going to do, we are going to do simply create a line here, okay, simple line, give it a offset of 0.1 meter, and then now press escape. And now we are create a door of only 0.9 meter, because the entrance of the door, washroom and bathroom, attached washroom and bathroom is around 0.9 meter or 1 meter, but we are taking a 0.9, so again offset 0.9 meter, enter, give it offset, now press escape. Now what we are going to do, we are going to select this area, press TR, enter. These two, okay, we don't need them, these two also, okay, press escape. Now we don't need that lines. Now we are extend this kind of to here, entrance of the washroom is created, for the bedroom is created. Now we are going to create a, sorry, we also trim this part, okay, so simply control press A or select all and press, give a command of trim. Now simply click here and press escape. Now what we are going to do, we are going to delete this line and extend this line up to here for EX from here. Now trim this line, control A, TR, enter. Now our dining area is open. Now what we are going to do, we are trim this area also. Okay, for that I can create a line to here. This is the reference size, we don't need it, so we can trim it after work done, our work is done. So control A, TR, enter, simply select all these layer lines, simply click on trim it. Now delete these two lines, we don't need it, so create a line again here. And now also we are, sorry, control C, select this, TR, enter. Now we can apply fillet here, so F, enter, here, and here we are selected. Now our opening for living area and stair area is open, okay. So now we are going to create a door here, okay. For that I simply draw a reference line here and give a offset of 0.1 meter and okay. Now I delete this line, we don't need it. Now again we give a offset of 0.9 for the door and click here and here, escape, select this area, press TR for trim, enter. Now this, select these two lines and again these two lines also. Now openings are created here. Now what we are going to do, we are delete this extra lines, okay. So TR, enter. Now simply select them and delete them. Simply press OK. We also delete this layer by trim this lines. Okay, so simply okay. Now pretty much good. Now here is a one door is also available for give a back to go a backyard. For that I will create a reference line here. Okay. Now give it the offset of 0.1, sorry, offset of 0.1 meter from here, and again give a offset of 1.2 meter. Okay, now we are going to escape and cancel this command, and we are going to trim this by pressing TR. Select these two, press escape, delete this line because now we do not need this. Okay, pretty much good. Now what we are going to do, we are going to create a simple door for the coming to the kitchen. Now we are don't need to do it because there is a this wall is no need here. This wall is not own plan, so we can delete this wall. Only this area is open and this wall is up to here only, okay. So we give a reference line here and give a offset of 0.1 2 meter from here to here. Okay, now delete this line. Now give a offset of a 2 meter from here to here. Okay, now simply trim this. Now here and here up to here, there is a platform of kitchen is. Now you can see here I can put it here. Our door is created. Now this door I can give a parameters. For that I will go to the block editor and edit it. For that I will simply press the B and enter. Now I can give a name it door and enter door, and simply pick a point. So I am pick a point from here, and now I can select the object which is here and simply right click. Now you can see here it shows the preview. Now what we are going to do, we are click here. If it is unchecked, click here either either you can leave it as it is, open in block editor and simply click on OK. Now you can see our block editor is open. Now go to parameters, simply go to linear, go to flip and choose a point, first point here, another one is here, okay, and at almost sector I can again click to give this here. Now I can move this arrow from here to almost at middle, okay. Now again I can give a flip parameter from here to here and give it here, okay. So I can little bit up, go to up here and release it. Now I can give it action for the flip. Go to actions, click on flip. Now choose a parameter or select a parameter so I can check the flip state 1. Click on it. Now I can select the object of our door and select it and right click. Now you can see here flip icon is shown here. Now I can move it towards here, okay, with this arrow. Now I can give again flip with the flip state 2, select parameter, select object, right click. Now you can see here again flip parameter is also shown. Now we are going I am going to move this up to here. Now again go to parameters, go to linear and give it to here to here and okay distance, okay. Now we are going to actions and give it a scale so that I can simply click on scale, choose distance 1, select object our door and simply right click. Now you can see scale parameter is activate. Now I again go to parameters and simply give it to a rotation parameter. For that I can simply click on here. Now I can give it from here the base point to end point and up to this 90 degree, okay. Simply click here and move it to little bit under. Now I can give action of rotation. So simply click on rotation, select an angle. Now I'm going to select our object, right click. Now you can see here our rotation is activate. Rotation action is activate. Now our door is ready for the use. Now simply click on close editor. Now it asks for the save changes, so you can save it. Now you can simply click on the door. You can see here the two types of arrow and one circular point. Now by this arrow you can scale it smaller or scale up, okay, and by this you can flip it, and by this point you can rotate up to 360 degrees, okay. So now we are putting this door, okay. So simply CD for the copy and enter and choose a base point over here, put it at the middle point here, other one is here, one here. Now okay for now. Now what we are going to do, I'm going to do scale it up because they need it. Okay. Now scale to 1. Now I am going to flip it and move it. And sorry. Now again I'm going to flip it. Okay. And now I'm going to move it by pressing M and enter. Now choose the base point, midpoint. Now I'm going to scale. Okay. Now for this I reduce the scale into here. Now we have created a door over here. Sorry, this door is wrong. This is open at under. Now it is correct. Now we have created another copy from here to here and simply flip it. Okay, simply copy this from here to midpoint here. Okay. Okay, now our doors are placed at correct places. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we are going to create our windows. Okay, so now first window is here, another one is here, there is a two windows and one door, here one window, here one, here two windows. This is the glass windows and one other is over here. Okay, so for that what we are going to do, we are going to create a line and simply go to, sorry, first of all we are going to change the what can I say, layers to the, go to windows layer, now select line at midpoint, we are going to create a line, escape, or simply give a offset of 0.6 meter both the sides. Okay, so now escape and delete this line. Now what we are going to do, we are trim this line. Okay, now what we are going to do, we are create a line here. here, okay. Now I can give a offset of the wall is of 0.3 meters, so I can give a offset of 0.15, okay. Give a offset of 15. I'm going to give a offset of 0.70. Okay. Now our first window is ready. Now create another window here. Simply choose a midpoint. Escape. Give an offset of a point, sorry, 0.6 meter both the sides. Delete this trim. Now create the lines. Give an offset of 0.3. Again, give offset of 0.17. Okay. Now, here is 1.9 meter door, and here two windows are provided. For that, what I'm going to do, I again go to line, choose midpoint. Okay. Now again offset of 0.6 meter both the sides. Okay, now measure the distance, okay, from here to here. There is a 2.2 meter, so what we are going to do, here is a 1.2 meter, so let's open notepad. 2.2 meter, and the distance from here also, I guess 1.2 meter, sorry, 2.2 meter. Okay, 2.2 meter. Okay. Now we are provided a window of 1.2 meter here and 1.2 meter here. So 2.2 minus 1.2 means 1 meter, so I can give first of all delete this line and give a offset of 0.5 meter from here to here and here to here. Now again give offset of 1.2 meter here to here and here to here. Now select all these lines and take a command of trim by pressing TR. Simply delete these two, and these two. Okay. Now go to line. Simply sorry, I forgot it. It's not a window here, it is a door here. So I can delete these lines and go to doors. And first of all, go to walls layer and draw a line to here. Okay, now again go to doors. And simply copy this door, by CP and move it from here to here and select again and place it original position at the midpoint here. Okay, now let's get back to the windows layer, and here give a offset of 0.17 meter. Okay, here. Okay, also here. Now our window is created from here area. Now we are going to create a window here and here on the floor. Okay, here is the garage, so no need to create a window here. So one window is here, so I can go to line, go to the midpoint and give a offset of 0.6 meters. Okay, now choose a trim command, erase this line, delete this line. Now simply create here and here. Now give an offset of 0.17. Come here to here to here. Okay, now again if you look here, there is a very big window. So I can go to the walls layer and draw a line here and here. Okay, because here is a window, very big window, it means it's a showcase window. Okay, so I can simply give a window here, create a line to here. Okay, and create another line which is from here to here. Now go to the windows panel and simply trim off. Now create a line from here to here. Okay, now give a offset of 0.17 both the sides. Now our window is created. Now we are going to create a window, one here and one here. Okay, and two windows are here. So simply click on line, choose a midpoint here and here also. Give an offset of 0.6 meter both the sides. Now press escape to exit, select all this, press DR. Okay, delete these two lines, simply go to here. Again, create a line here, give an offset of 0.70. windows are ready. Now what we are going to do, here also a window. Okay, so we are create that window also. Now I can realize that this window is not this much long, this is up to here only, so I can reduce the size of window. Now then go to walls layer and extend this line up to here and create another line to here. Okay, now get back to the windows layer, and now what we are going to do, I'm going to measure this distance. Okay, from here here. It's a 4.10 meter. So again, I am open the notepad. What is it? 4.10, I think. Yeah, it's 4.10. So it's a 4.10 meter. So I can half by 2.05. Okay. At 2.05 there is a midpoint of it. Okay, so I can simply draw a line here at the midpoint. Okay, now this is the 2.05 this way and 2.05 this way, so I can simply, that means 2.05 minus 1.2. Okay, I can open the calculator. Okay. Now 2.05 divided by 2. Sorry. We have a distance 2.05 minus 1.2 0.85 divided by 2. Now we are going to give an offset of 4.2 0.42 both the sides. Okay, now again I can give an offset of 1.2 meter this way and this way, and I can delete this line, I don't need it. Now trim this area, okay. Now I am going to create a window here and here. Okay, now simply give an offset of 0.17 . Now you can see here are almost drawing is complete. Okay, so in first part, now we are going to create a walls with the accurate dimensions, put a doors and window at its place. Okay, so first part, this is now this is completed. In second part, I will going to show you how to give a dimension for this and add text here, here and here. Okay, and we are going to also put a means we are going to put a some for okay furniture here and all this plan. Okay, so one thing I forgot to do, so I can do it. So go to walls layer, simply click here and here. Now I can hatch this area. Okay, so for that hatch, I will go to here and here and simply I can choose this angle. You can choose from anything from here, but I will choose here this one. I will put it here. And here also. Okay, and one thing I also forgot, I hope that is here also we can put the area. Okay, this is the sitting area. Now I can also put hatch here also here. Now our main plan is completed, our first part is completed. See you in the next tutorial. Till then, goodbye, and please like my video, share and comment down below, and do not forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.